Hello my dear students, our today's topic is Coulomb's law, a very important topic of this chapter. This law is analog to the Newton's law of gravitation that we have learned in the class 11th. Consider we have two point charges placed at point A and at point B. See, Q1 is placed at A and Q2 is placed at point B, and both the charges are separated by a distance r. Coulomb found that the force between these two charges is proportional to the product of the magnitude of the charge. Say Q1 is the magnitude of the charge placed at A and Q2 is the magnitude of the charge placed at point B. So he found that the force between, the force may be attractive, may be repulsive, but it is directly proportional to the product of the magnitude of charges. It means ki hum jitne bhi charges ka magnitude zyada lete hain, फोर्स उतनी ही ज्यादा एक्ट करती है बिटवीन द चार्जेस. सो फोर्स इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू प्रोडक्ट ऑफ द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ द चार्जेस. ओके, द नेक्स्ट ऑब्जर्वेशन, सी दिस इज द क्वेश्चन फर्स्ट. द फोर्स बिटवीन द टू चार्जेस इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द स्क्वायर ऑफ द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन देम. वी हैव कंसिडर्ड द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द टू चार्जेस इज आर. और ये कूलम ने ऑब्जर्व किया कि जितना हम डिस्टेंस ज्यादा करते हैं उनकी जो फोर्स है उतनी कम होती जाती है. मींस अगर चार्ज ज़्यादा नज़दीक हैं उनके बीच की फोर्स ज़्यादा होगी, अगर हम उनका डिस्टेंस इंक्रीज कर देंगे देन द फोर्स विल बिकम लेस. ओके, सो दिस इज द सेकेंड इक्वेशन. फोर्स इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू Q1 Q2 एंड इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू आर स्क्वायर. कंबाइनिंग दीज टू इक्वेशंस व्हाट वी विल गेट इज Q2 over R square, and removing this proportionality sign, so in place of proportionality sign we will write here K constant, Coulomb's constant. Say Q1 Q2 over R square is now our new equation, and this K is constant of proportionality. In SI system of units, K is written as 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught. This 4 is a constant, pi is a constant, and epsilon naught is absolute permittivity of free space or vacuum, because we are considering the two charges are placed in free space or in vacuum. Okay, the value of this epsilon naught is 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12. And the unit for this is Coulomb square per Newton per meter square. How to find the units, I will discuss with you later. Okay, so 4 is constant, pi is constant, epsilon naught is also constant for vacuum. So on solving the values, or on putting the values of all these constants and on solving, we will get K is equals to 9 into 10 to the power 9. And the unit for this is Newton meter square per Coulomb square. So from this expression, we will write here first, the value of K is 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 over R square. And then F is equal to 9 into 10 to the power 9 Q1 Q2 over R square. So this is the final expression of Coulomb's law. So simple. Now what is the definition of this Coulomb's law? So it states that the two point charges attract or repel each other with a force which is directly proportional to the product of the magnitude of the charges and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. So directly proportional, inversely proportional, on combining the two factors, this is the final expression. And this is how you need to write the full derivation of this law. Okay. So what was the K in this expression? K is the constant of proportionality. And in SI, K is 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught, whose value is 9 into 10 to the power 9. How do we get this 9 into 10 to the power 9? On putting the value of this epsilon naught, which is 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12 Coulomb square per Newton per meter square. Now next topic is how to find the units of these epsilon naught or K. One more thing I want to discuss with you, what is this epsilon naught called? This is called absolute permittivity. This is called absolute permittivity. Absolute permittivity जो है, जिसे हम epsilon से लिखते हैं, अगर आपको epsilon समझ में नहीं आ रहा तो इसको मैं लिख देता हूं आपके लिए, epsilon, epsilon, epsilon इसे हम लिखते हैं, और epsilon zero भी बोलते हैं इसे, epsilon naught भी बोलते हैं इसे. So epsilon naught, actually the force between the two charges also depend upon the medium in which the two charges are placed. So the permittivity is the characteristic property of a medium which affects the magnitude of the force between the two charges. More is the value of permittivity, lesser will be the force. जितनी permittivity किसी भी space की ज्यादा होगी, किसी भी medium की ज्यादा होगी, वहां पे दो charges में लगने वाली force उतनी कम होगी, because the epsilon naught here is in the denominator, or we say that the force is inversely proportional to the permittivity. Okay. So next is our how to find the units of the epsilon naught. From this expression, which is 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught, these two things are constant. These two things are constant. 4 and pi are constant. So what we are left with here, Q1, Q2 over epsilon naught r square. Epsilon naught is equal to Q1 Q2 over F times R square. So Q is charge, Q2 is charge. So coulomb into coulomb, coulomb square. Force is in Newton and the unit for the distance are meter, so meter square. So coulomb square per Newton per meter square. So the units for the epsilon naught, coulomb square per Newton per meter square. In the same way, by proceeding in the same way, you can find out the units for the K. Okay. So now let me define one coulomb of charge. हम one coulomb को कैसे define करते हैं? So we have the two charges Q1 and Q2 separated by the distance r distance. So for defining the one coulomb of charge, we suppose is, say Q1 is equal to Q2 is equal to Q, means both the charges are of same magnitude and same nature as well. We are considering both the charges are positive and we are considering the magnitude of Q1 is equal to the magnitude of the Q2. And both the magnitude of the both the charges is equal to Q, say. Okay. And we are considering the distance between the two charges is 1 meter, and both the charges are placed in vacuum. Okay. And the force between the two charges is 9 into 10 to the power 9 Newton. Now from the expression, F is equal to 9 into 10 to the power 9 Q1 Q2 over R square. ये वही expression है जो हमने drive किया था यहाँ पे. मैंने उसी कूलम्स लॉ का फाइनल एक्सप्रेशन वहां पे लिखा है. ओके, नाउ ये वाली वैल्यूज हम इस एक्सप्रेशन में पुट कर देंगे. सो फोर्स इज 9 इंटू 10 टू द पावर 9. फोर्स की वैल्यू मैंने यहां पे रख दी 9 इंटू 10 टू द पावर 9, और ये ऑलरेडी यहां पे है 9 इंटू 10 टू द पावर 9. एंड Q1 Q2 जो चार्जेस हैं, बोथ द चार्जेस आई हैव कंसीडर्ड ऑफ द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ Q. सो Q1 is Q, Q2 is Q, so Q into Q, Q square over R square, and R is 1 meter, so 1 square. So on solving this, this will cancel with this, so 1 is equal to Q square over 1, so Q square is equal to 1, or Q is equal to plus minus 1, because this is charge, so this will be unit for the charge is coulomb. So हमने one coulomb charge हमें कब मिला? हमें one coulomb charge तब मिला जब दो charges थे, वो दोनों ही same magnitude के थे, same nature के थे, both we have considered of the same kind. तो जब उनमें फोर्स लगी 9 × 10⁻⁹ न्यूटन, तो हम इसको डिफाइन करने के लिए ऐसा बोलते हैं कि किसी भी एक पर्टिकुलर चार्ज को, जैसे इस चार्ज को मैं 1 कूलम का तब कहूंगा जब ये एक इक्वल एंड सिमिलर चार्ज को रिपेल करेगा कितनी फोर्स से, 9 × 10⁹ न्यूटन फोर्स से, जब पड़े होंगे वैक्यूम में और कितने डिस्टेंस पे, 1 मीटर डिस्टेंस पे, तब इस चार्ज को हम बोलेंगे 1 कूलम्ब ऑफ चार्ज। मीन्स जब ये चार्ज किसी दूसरे चार्ज को, सिमिलर एंड इक्वल चार्ज को रिपेल करेगा विद अ फोर्स ऑफ 9 × 10⁹ न्यूटन व्हेन प्लेस्ड इन वैक्यूम इन अ डिस्टेंस 1 मीटर अपार्ट। सो द डेफिनेशन ऑफ दिस, सो 1 कूलम्ब इज दैट चार्ज विच रिपेल्स एन इक्वल एंड सिमिलर चार्ज विद अ फोर्स ऑफ 9 × 10⁹ न्यूटन व्हेन प्लेस्ड इन वैक्यूम एट अ डिस्टेंस ऑफ 1 मीटर फ्रॉम इट।